this role of Sally Bowles and the kind of image of you, like, sprawled across that chair and the bowler hat and everything, mm-hmm. it's like a worldwide iconic image.
Yes.
How does that feel?
It feels great. Except, you know that one poster where I've got my hands on the top of the chair like this? Mm-hmm. That's not my body.
What?
It's not my body. I have longer legs and a shorter torso.
Whose body is it?
I have no idea. I've never told anybody. I never have.
Oh, I must look at that picture again.
You've got to. Maybe this time I'll
be lucky. Maybe this Liza time was the daughter of Hollywood royalty. Her mother was child star Judy Garland, and her father, Vincente Minnelli, was a director of Hollywood musicals. And Vincente knew a thing or two about how a 30s performer should look.
I told my father I was going to, you know, make my hair blonde and do this. And he said, no. He said, no. And he showed me pictures of Louise Brooks and all of the dark-haired stars of that time. So I dyed my hair blacker and cut it in the point. And then I went to a store and... as I went through, she sold eyelashes. I thought...
no.
Right. So, I bought these eyelashes.
Well, that was the start of the Sally Bowles, the Liza mm-hmm. lashes.
Yes. Now, we're in Germany, and I figured out this look. And I thought, I guess I better show this to Bob, right?
Yeah.
Put on the whole makeup, lashes, and knocked on the door, and I said, you like it? He said, what did you... yes, thank God.
Oh, phew. Everybody is so attracted to her. People want to be her. Why do you think people are so into her?
Because you care about her.
Because she's wounded.
Yeah. Something that they cared about. You know, and it may not be the same thing.
One thing is, each and everyone a virgin.
The women, who were the dancers,
yeah.
They came in the audition, and it was an American musical, you know. So they got really dressed up, and they were just, you know, best makeup, and this, that, the other. And then Bobby hired them, and then they put all that makeup on them, with the bruises, yeah. and they're going, was ist los, you know, what's happening?
Bob Fosse had a very... clear vision for this film, and how did he communicate that to you?
To the artists of the time. You know, if you think of all of different shots in the Club of the People, they're very specific to the different painters mm-hmm. of the time.
He's mesmerized by mein hair. That must have been exhausting. Is that why you've got two false hips?
Probably. I look at some of those poses and think, oh my God, how did I do? They were so hard to do because... you know, when you're like this and leaning on the chair, and then this leg is way back here, so you're literally like that, right? Yeah. With your legs. The chair kept sliding. And finally, after about 20 minutes, he said, nail the chair down! And that's the only way that we could shoot his poses.
Ooh, show his secrets. When you went to Berlin, you kind of really immersed yourself in that culture and everything.
Yes, and talking to people, older people, who've been around.
Yeah.
You know?
And what did people think about the fact that there was this kind of Americanized version of what had gone on?
Well, they were a little weird about it. I mean, we're going to Germany to film a movie about the Nazis. What are we going to call it? The Nifty Nazi Follies? No, I mean, come on. So, I mean, when they dressed all these guys who were cast as the Nazis... you know, we found them hiding. You know, they didn't even want to be seen.
Right.
You know, so when it came out, they realized that it was really important. It changed the vision of homosexuality at that point. The people were still kind of more private and hiding more. They felt they had to. And this influenced that, I think, Cabaret.
Yeah.
It helped.
Well, it opens people's minds to other possibilities.
Absolutely.
Is life a cabaret, Liza?
Oh, absolutely. Look at all the stuff that happens to you.
in these episodes.
You just keep going on.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm still hoofing away.
Stop by admitting.